Hey everybody. Okay, so we're almost done quantifying the ideas of heat of solution. And in this video, which will hopefully be about 5 or 6 minutes long, maybe a little bit longer, we're going to wrap it all up. Before we get back to our big fancy slide up there, I want to remind you what we are really aiming for by drawing your attention over here. Remember I showed you the demonstration of ammonium nitrate that got cold when we dissolved it. So we had an endothermic heat of solution with ammonium nitrate. And I told you that if we did the same experiment, if we just took some lithium chloride and dissolved it in water, we would have gotten an exothermic heat of solution. So again, our goal here is to try to rationalize why some solutions, why some salts, when you dissolve them in water, make a cold solution, and why some make a warm solution or a hot solution. That's where we're headed. And our last bit of discussion here about the heat of hydration will hopefully allow us to be able to do that. So I'm going to go ahead and get rid of my beakers and myself and bring back our slide. Okay, so here's our big scary slide. We've covered just about everything on the big scary slide except for the stuff down here. So we described how the heat of solution can be quantified in terms of H1, which is our opposite of lattice enthalpy. It's how much the energy of the system is going up as we expand the solute, and this concept of heat of hydration. And heats of hydration are always exothermic. When we allow the ions to interact with water, that enthalpy portion is more negative than it cost us to expand the solvent, right? So when we combine H2 and H3 to heat of hydration, the net result is that it's going to be negative. Let's take a look now at some values for the heat of hydration by going over to this part of our diagram. So I have listed here some different cations of group 1 and group 2. Now the analysis I'm going to lead you through would work exactly the same if we were talking about anions. I'm just limiting the conversation here to cations. So I have here a list of different cations, group 1 and group 2 cations, and their heats of hydration, right? These are experimentally determined values for the heats of hydration. What do we notice? There are two aspects that are changing as we go from these different ions. When we go from lithium to sodium to potassium, obviously the charge is staying the same. Then when we jump to magnesium, calcium, and strontium, we are changing the charge. When we go from lithium to sodium to potassium, the size of the ion is getting larger. When we go from magnesium to calcium to strontium, the size of the ion is also getting larger. So we have two effects here that we have to pay attention to, right? And I show you the sizes down here in good old-fashioned picometers. Remember, picometers, atomic dimensions are usually in the hundreds of picometers, and you can see that that's true here, right? We have some near 100 picometers, but mostly things are in hundreds of picometers. So what you notice first is that all the plus two ions have a more exothermic heat of hydration compared to all the plus one ions. That should make some sense, right? The water molecule should want to gravitate towards a more positively charged ion than it does a less positively charged ion. That ion-dipole interaction is going to be more favorable as the ion has more charge. So we see there's quite a big jump from the plus ones to the plus twos. They're more exothermic. I'm not going to talk about the heat of hydration being larger or smaller. I'm going to put it in the context of being more or less exothermic. So that's charge, and then you can also see a size effect. As the ion gets larger, you see that the heat of hydration becomes less exothermic. As the ion gets larger, you see the heat of hydration become less exothermic. So we have these two factors, charge and size. We can actually combine the two factors into one concept called charge density. Charge density is pretty much what it sounds like. It's the amount of charge per unit size, per unit volume. So we're going to kind of play a little bit of an ion-dipole dating game. Let's pretend you're water. And the first dating game you get to play is between, if you're a water molecule, do you want to date a plus one ion or a plus two ion? Which ion are you going to have a stronger affinity for? Well, based on the results we're seeing over here for the heats of hydration, you are going to have more of an affinity for the plus two ion, right? Charge is a pretty big factor here. Now, if you're a water molecule and you could go ahead and date a plus one ion of small size or a plus one ion of larger size, which one are you going to gravitate towards? Which one will you have the higher affinity for? Well, the water molecule is going to want to date the smaller charge, okay? So charge and size can be wrapped up in this idea of charge density. So as the charge density gets larger, because either the charge gets larger or the size of the ion gets smaller, as the charge density increases, the heat of hydration for that ion is going to get more exothermic. On our chart over here, magnesium, calcium, and strontium all have greater charge densities than lithium, sodium, and potassium because they have a greater charge. Lithium has a greater charge density than potassium because it's smaller, and so therefore it has a more exothermic heat of hydration. So we have this idea of charge density. As the charge density increases, the heat of hydration becomes more exothermic, which now brings us back to ammonium nitrate and lithium chloride. Think about those two salts. Why is it then that ammonium nitrate gave an endothermic heat of solution and lithium chloride gave an exothermic heat of solution? You should be able to rationalize this now in terms of the relative magnitudes of H1 expanding the solute and the magnitude of the heat of hydration. Think that through. Can you rationalize that ammonium nitrate is endothermic and lithium chloride is exothermic, now knowing what you know about H1 and heats of hydration? All right, that's it for this video. We'll see you in class.